Thank you. So they have identified those pages where you want to use the protection. The next step is to identify where the elements within those pages, within each page, so each page. And really, that's how it's helpful to break up down into two separate categories. The first one being the case of the code. The second one being the on-site analysis, so that's CSS, JavaScript, and pages. And then the remaining categories and parts, most often those are drivers and SDSS, it could be video points, it could be some kind of network. But in most cases, the assets from probably some kind of network. Before all of these, the main project has to be where it gets tested. Is there anybody who listens to code? Yeah, it's a great thing. It's a big thing, it gives you a lot of great information. And you have to have a way to develop the information for the algorithm, for example, for something. But at the top, it gives you some high-level information on how your site works, you know, some initial steps and where the main part of it is. It gives you lots of different metrics to sort of get that picture. And it also gives you this nice whiteboard for not only the page load, but all the different requests that go into supporting that page load. And you can see that you have to send an example of the way you handle this separate piece of paper. So the next thing that you need is this connection, which essentially takes all of those requests for individual assets and then sort of puts them online. So you can see all of the assets loaded within a single connection. We're going to talk a little bit later about how this one can be used. We're going to also just say that you are interested in those individual requests, so they'll also give you a way to get to the So coming back to our three sections, how you can look at this within the types of work that you can do. The first one is really that, you know, the paper itself. What we can highlight are ways to place on-site assets, so again, CSS, JavaScript, images, and then what's left would be a third-party asset. But if we go back to that connection, you can see that it really nicely visualizes, you know, how much weight is being received by each of those, so now we've collected all of that data into our column pages, and we're going to need to diagnose them to figure out what exactly is going to improve the situation. So the first thing that we talked about is picture. Do you see the two metric on the screen for the first one time? And you can see an example of the first one time over 2 seconds. Then you need to start kind of work with 500 milliseconds of time you want to dive into the issues in the picture. If you need to go deeper and get even more data, there are some tricks you can use, and I'll talk about these one by one. So the first one is site audit. The examples I'm showing here are from the site. Unfortunately, at least for our site, because the person is not quite so video, but particularly if you're doing analysis on the sound set, this can be really helpful. So as we go through, you can see there are a variety of categories here. They're basically giving you specific recommendations for each one, where you're not sort of aligned with best practice. So you can see here as an example, it's got a piece of detail to something that you can definitely help with on your site. But as you go through, a lot of the different options can be established to take that and use to get these different categories that are maybe aligned with the topics that you're taking about. So the next thing you can use is you've got pictures commercial, driving commercial, one thing here is to give you that historical timeline, so if you recently deployed code kind of flow, you can see if that aligns with where the sunset flow aligns with the deployed code. So that can be really useful. There's a lot of different things on the stack where there could be analysis based on the functions of consuming time, but there are even retaining the ability to application from the data that you have already determined. So you can see here where looks like something happened probably around the cause that one particular functionality was done, and it became a much greater contributor to the overall network to make the site, and so that's definitely something that we want to sort of add to the system so we get a much more accurate report. And then the same way as the module level, we Thank you. we I was designing the home so I could set up to create the connector system that tracks the home.
Thank you.